Kyle's old 801 Ford Pirate Master. It's got power steering, so it's a pretty good little tractor. We're gonna restore it, so we're gonna start by sanding this hood down. Here's what it looks like right now. I'm gonna start sanding on the hood. If I could take you up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom, tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. So as you can see, I've done a good bit of work to it since the last time I showed you guys. I took the steering wheel off, I took the light off, the grill and the bumper, and this little badge right here. And I've got all this down to just bare metal. And it's this side's not, but this side I haven't messed with yet. But so the sander I was using right here, it's all right, but it was just taking forever. So I got this electric grinder with a sandpaper and disc wheel on it, and it just eats away the paint. And then it leaves like little scratches in here that'll show up on the paint, but I just take the sander and it'll get the scratches out. So that's just what I've been doing. So the whole tractor so far, and we got all it down to bare metal. So I gotta do this side over here still yet. I gotta take the light off. And then once we get it all sanded down, then I'll take it off the tractor and then paint it. But I got a lot of work to do. If I could take you up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom, tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Life could be a dream. And I think I'm glad you come to you. And I think I'm my whole life loving you. I got the tractor down to bare metal now. So it's rough right now. It's got deep scratches that'll show up in paint and stuff, but I'll just have to take the sander, go over the whole tractor really good and get all the scratches out and make it all smooth. And there's also some little places that needs a little body work, and there's a little bit of rust right here. I'm gonna make sure I get all the rust out, send it down and fill it in with body filler. And there's a couple other little dents here and there. I'm gonna have to sand this down. It's the only part that ain't got the paint off yet, but I got everything else done. Sit in between here too, is a little side light off. So now there's pretty much nothing left on it except for the front with the gauge cluster and stuff and all the wires hooking up to the ignition and stuff. So other than that, the hood will be ready to come off soon. Probably sometime tomorrow I might take it off. But then I gotta probably put some tiles on the paint and stuff and try to fix the leaks and then get this all washed up. I don't know how much sanding I'll do to this just because it's just the frame, and I mean it's gonna get beat up and stuff and oil is gonna leak on it because this tractor's 50 years old. We won't really probably ever be able to fix all the leaks on it, but we'll get the big ones because you can see it's leaking pretty decent right now. But yeah, it's also leaking pretty good right here too. So we'll just purple power it down and wash it real good with the pressure washer, and then probably spray this part just red, and then this middle strip's gonna be red, and then these are gonna be the cream white color that Ford has for these year model tractors. Hello, hello again, shaboom, and hope to meet again. Oh, life could be a dream, shaboom, and I think I'm glad you come to you, shaboom, and I think I'm my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. This is what all we got done the first day. Guess we'll come back up tomorrow and see what else we can do. This would look pretty good if it was just clear coated. I took a wire wheel to get in between all this, and it kind of polished it. And if you clear coat over that, it looked pretty cool, but I don't know. We'll probably paint it back the original color.
I've got the tractor sanded down to bare metal now everywhere. Smooth it out with the sander. We got some body work done here, 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 and here. And we got it all detached from the tractor, so we're fixing to take this off and then maybe paint some. I got the hood off now. It's sitting right there. It's all sanded down, ready to go. I think I'm going to pressure wash it next, just so I can get all the grease and wool and stuff off the frame. Here's what it looks like now that it's all washed up. If you pressure wash your tractor, make sure you cover these two up, because if water gets in there, it won't crank and you'll have to dry it all out in this big rigmarole. So just cover it up, and then when you get done pressure washing, uncover it, make sure it's dry, and then if it is a little bit wet, let it dry out. But it's all washed up and got most of the oil off. It's a lot more shinier now than it was. I got the hood over here and here because it's bare metal now. I don't want it to rust. So. Just to dry in here and did all the body work and stuff today, so it's ready to paint. I need to do a little work on the inside because I forgot about it, but it should be ready to go now. If I could take you up in tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Alright, so I got some paint sprayed down. It's not perfect. I mean, it's pretty good. It's got a little water droplets in there because I forgot to drain my air compressor. And I don't have a water separator. And there's a couple little runs that I need to sand back down and smooth up whenever I do it, because the paint was just a bit thin. I mixed up. And also there's a couple little spots where bugs landed on it. But this hood, side of the hood and that side of the hood and the grill is going to be white. And then the middle part in the end is going to be red. So I just want to spray some white and see how it came out. I mean, it looks pretty smooth. I mean, here's where the Bondo was. I'll probably have to hit it again because I know it's going to soak up a lot of paint. So I'll probably spray the whole thing, fix the blemishes, and then spray the whole thing again. And then the grill needs to be sprayed a good bit more because it's kind of running out of paint whenever I was getting it. But yeah. Tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again. Shaboom, and hoping to meet again. Oh, life could be a dream. Shaboom, and I think I'm glad you come to you. And I think I'm my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. You, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to, baby, we'd be so far. Oh, life in a ding-dong. If I could take you up in push, tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Pretty well ready to go now. I was gonna buy fenders, but I couldn't find any for this tractor, so I just had to fix the ones that was on it. They were in pretty bad shape. This was the worst part here. It was cracked, and I don't have a welder to weld it back together. So what I had to do was come right here and put a piece of metal, go bend this back into place and put that metal there to secure it, and then rivet it on. But I got Bondo'd all up where it's smooth now. I just got a couple of places I still gotta sand out. But yeah, these should be ready to paint. And then I got the box that was on here sanded down, ready to paint, and the light sanded down, ready to paint. So everything should be ready to paint. So we got that done. And I think I'm my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open the meet again. Oh, life could be a dream. Shaboom. And I think I'm glad you come through. And I think I'm my whole life loving you. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. here's the tractor all tore down. I took the gas tank off of it because it has a little crack in it right here. So I ordered a new gas tank. I found out where majority of the oil leaks were. The valve cover gasket's leaking. The oil pan gasket's leaking. I got both those on the way. So they should be here within probably a week or so. If the power steering fluid's leaking a little bit around the seal of the cap, so I'm going to have to replace that as well. And like I said, I got a new gas tank coming as well. I got the fenders all painted up. I'll show you guys in a second. They turned out pretty good for how bad they were, but we got them all painted up and fixed, so they're spray painted. The backside still maybe spray painted, but that's the only thing I have left. I had to wait till today, but now it's raining. I was gonna paint the backside so I could flip them over, but like I said, it's raining now. And then I have to paint the wheels. That's the only other thing I think I have to paint white, and the rest will be red. But I want to get these gaskets replaced, and maybe before I paint, I'm not 100% sure yet. Just have to see how long it takes for them to come in. And the gas tank should be in around the same time too, but I think it's already painted, so I don't have to worry about it. And everything else is coming along pretty good. Hopefully it'll be finished up within a week or so. But I just got a cold or strep throat or something, so it's been kind of slowing me down. I haven't really been feeling like working much. We're also wanting to get a seat, but I haven't found one yet because that seat's pretty trash. He's wanting to get like the older style, just like the metal seat, because he said that he liked that one better. So we're gonna try to find a seat too, but I'll show you guys the fenders. Here's the fenders. They turned out pretty good. There was that big old weld down both of them right here where they had been broke or something previous, and somebody replaced them, repaired them. And then there was this little edge that was cracked that we fixed. You can't even tell it now. Here's the center console and the box. Both of those came out pretty good. And this is the light bracket. So everything looks pretty good. Here's the little run I was talking about that I'm gonna sand back down and get out. That's just some dirt around it where my hands was dirty and I touched it. But they turned out pretty good. It would have been better to buy new ones, but we couldn't really find anything. We just buy the skins that go over them and then you weld them into place. We don't have a welder, like I said, so this was the best option. So it turned out pretty good. For the rocker assembly, and it fell out and was laying right there, and it got all chewed up, bent up. So, and then this is cracked as well. So I don't know if that caused that or what, but it's not good. So I painted that part gray, and then the gauge cluster, and then the front. So the whole hood's gonna be gray now. So I've got the valve cover back on now, and I'm working on sanding the tractor down. I've got a pretty good bit of it sanded down, but there's still a good bit more to sand down. I'm not getting it down to bare metal like I did the hood. I'm just getting all the flaking paint off and like the uneven paint. We also ordered a new seat, new cables for the negative side. It's positive and negative on 6-volt. And we've got another starter to solenoid wire as well, and then we got a whole nother wiring kit, and then some stickers, some decals that says Ford 801 Powermaster. So I think they're all coming today, and also brand new gauges, voltage regulator, odometer, oil pressure, and temperature gauge. So all that should be coming today, and hopefully I can start spraying red on the frame tomorrow, if I get enough sand done today. It's coming out pretty good, better than I thought it was going to. I got the grill painted over there, and then the air cleaner, whatever it's called over there. We got the muffler taped off, the gas line taped off, starter solenoid taped off, the carburetor stuff taped off. I'm gonna change the oil and change the filter, so I ain't gonna worry about that. I took the starter out, I took the generator out, I unhooked the power steering pump over here, I took the coil off and painted it, also painted the generator, and then I took the distributor cap off and I taped it up. So everything that I didn't want painted, I took off. Here's the generator and the coil that I painted earlier. So yeah, it's coming up pretty good. Put together now. I got the wheels back on, I got the seat on, the fenders on. I gotta change the oil pan gasket and do the wiring kit and change the freeze plugs, and then get the gauges through the mail because they still haven't came yet, and then put the hood back on. It should be ready to go. So we're almost done with it now. That's the hard part done with, at least now. So I got it all put back together. I'm just gonna throw a freeze plug in right here because it's got a little hole and the gauges still ain't came yet. And we're gonna have to get another light because the light right there don't work anymore, but that one works and the one on the back. But everything else is put back together. We'll crank it up here in just a second. But it turned out pretty good. It took a long time. I probably got over 100 hours on it so far. But it turned out pretty good. I don't know if I ever showed you or not, but I also painted these hoses black with some bed liner because I couldn't really find the hoses, so it looks a lot better like that. But we'll see if it cranks up here.